जांसु हृदय आकार असहिरां सरचाथर श्री हनुमते नमः। सूर्य भगवान आर्याय विद्महे प्रभातराय धीमहि तन्नः सूर्य प्रचोदयाय। भगवान
Thank you.
His name is Sri Krishna Chandra Vihari Ram Ki.
Thank you.
Principle of Sri Krishna Tantra Vihari Mahavi. So, today we read from the Bhagavad Gita, Katha discourse, the message is the greatness of Bhagwan, chapter 7, Sri Ramchandrapas. The greatness of Bhagwan Krishna, God to help our spiritual development, and we need His divine will. This divine intervention, as we hear these verses from the Bhagavad Gita, taken from chapter 7, I will explain about this divine. see to help the poor, the wounded, the sick. As you listen, we bow our heads and pray.
The earth, if we are the sun,
written something that the saints have longer kept moving around, totally. And then he says the water, the jal, yamunacha, 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 the water is very sacred, and puja is performed, Ganga water, Yamuna, he goes to the Yamuna river and collects some of the water that is very sacred. So you have Yamuna and Saraswati. So equivalent to that is when you place the Tulsi jal. So Bhagavan Krishna says, understanding that my divine presence is there, the water is very sacred, and if somebody has passed away, mantra is chanted to her love and give you all respect to the various elements. The Ida, Principal of Sri Prashachandra Vihani Malaki Jai, understanding good mind, which is very important, but he has best us the ability to use the mind either. So when the Kalash is worship, Manantra is practice, mantra, chanted the mantra, the mind should be focused on Bhagwan. It says, understanding this, the usage of the mind, says Bhagwan Krishna, the ego, constitute mind dual nature. And then when you are able to understand my divine greatness, brevity, all of us, goodness, some people are very happy to listen and chant to read. The function of this entire world, and for you to breathe properly, the prana, you see prana, 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 dana, dhyana, saman, the five values, the prana is the ability to breathe, where the wind would move upwards in this human body. So this is this mind. That will help us with stability of the mind, just with this mind alone. So it helps us to control the mind, the senses, and Kalash Puja is performed. The importance of gratitude to Bhagavan for my elements. So people will understand that I am the sustainer and the creator, see Bhagavan Krishna. Rasuham Absupauteya, Pradhashni Shasisurayo. I am the stability of the water, the secret scent of the water. You would taste the water, you know, you drink a glass of water, say, part of the glass in a nice cool glass of water. That divine taste itself is considered to be his presence in Bhagavan Krishna. So he teaches us to be humble and really, when you have the water to drink, celebrate it as samayatam, when you go for the water for the deities, the sustenance, a form of respect. So the water is quite important to help with our spiritual development, the purification, because the Tulsi jal will sprinkle the water to purify the atmosphere. And chant the mantra, we sprinkle water. So water is very secret in Bhagavad Krishna. He says, what now we speak about the Shashisrudeya, Prabhashmi Shashisrudeya, the radiance of the sun. The sun has the ability to transport energy. Now, Pratakala, when you wake up early in the morning time, face in the eastward direction, and to chant the devotee of Bhagavan Surya, Lord Krishna, you would hold the Lord Adhya. The greatest of Bhagavan chanting the mantra, Om Shri Surya, you would face in the eastward direction. That divine bliss of Surya Yoga, the body becomes energized. Again, Bhagavan Surya is the form of Krishna. Which is the sun and the moon, and this reference as well to the ashram of system, the deep subject of the auspicious states as the planets are also in the planets. So the sun and the moon plays an integral part, and whilst looking at the sun, if it is that somebody is unable to go and offer the tar living in another country and you just look at the sun, facing the sun. The blessing from Surya Deva, the sun Kranti, the month, the specific month that Lord Surya, that he enters a particular sign, is considered to be auspicious. So Lord Surya is here to help us strength and the moon. Even people with love to enjoy looking at the moon. So it says, I am present, the secret symbol. Who sings Bhagavan Krishna in the Vedas? the secret song, just gonna say that again, the secret song you were doing together was put on Krishna continues to explain where he resides, his divine greatness. Here in the song that we speak about, the Upanishads, the scriptures, when you listen to that song, the song should prove the importance of song, and you listen again. Shri Krishna Charanam. The song, Sarvabhupanishadam, that secret song according to the Vedas, some of us know is applicable if it is that you can study the Vedas. So, equivalent to the Vedas is the Bhagavad Gita, Chahu Purana Ashtadasha. By listening to the Sri Ramcharitmanas and the Bhagavad Gita, that is why the Gita is a prevalent scripture and the Sri Ramcharitmanas, new scriptures. So it says, if you are able to listen to the scriptures, antakali charmani nivad smaran uttavadhani vadam trivanda parvan throughout your life, and especially when you have passed. So listen to the song, listen to the divine song, says Bhagavan Krishna. And Omkaram bindu samyuktam yabhyananti yoginam kamadam mokshadam chaiva omkaraya namo namah. Omkaram bindu samyuktam. That is none other than divine lesson, Mokshiva itself. Well, we go to the Sri Ramcharitmanas. Shravan Kumar in the familiar Rome mantras to chant. Shravan Kumar would chant the Om. You remember his parents, right? And the good things that they have helped him, and he is concerned about their spiritual development, and just chanting that mantra Om. Om has the ability, before you chant the mantra to Lord Krishna, to stabilize the mind and the intellect, to receive his divine bliss and the greatness of God, right? To feel the positive vibration in order to help you to pray properly. The Om itself, so when you chant Om and you breathe in, inhale and exhale, then you become more full. So all of us will experience problems throughout our lives. So we're just telling this to you. We say just chant, take a moment to breathe in and breathe out. So the mantra Om itself has recommended by our, yes, Anudrigakaram Vakyam Satyam Priyahitam Chayat. Anudrigakaram Vakyam. Vakyam means words, the ability to speak. So when we are blessed with the opportunity to pray and chant the name of Bhagwan. Some of us, it's difficult for you to read the Sanskrit, the Hindi or English, or to remember these verses, then you just chant Om Hare Krishna Nirvana Gopal, as we listen to the Sri Ramcharitmanas before all words. We chant it, and then we continue again. Thank you. So that it is such a sense of weakening to acquire knowledge that the great sadhus, that is the life of Tulsidas, right? Tulsidas took the time to dedicate himself to Sri Ramachandra. What is one thing about your duty is there to serve the poor and rend sound of your seeking as well. Tulsidas traveled and listened to the name of Sri Ram and rather than greater Sri Ramachandra, even in the past night before, chanted Sri Ram's name to seek a name. When he was advised by his wife, his consort, to think about Sri Ram, how will be best for his gift to human body. And we spoke about the ability to think, to understand, to pray, the air, the atmosphere, the ability to breathe properly. Having this gift of this human body, feeling to understand who's responsible for that. So please, and then Tulsidas decided to live about Sri Ramachandra. And he was set aside to be weak, and the only belief is to acquire knowledge. But he listened to the verses from this Ram Kripa, through the divine intervention of Sri Ramachandra. He traveled in Kashi and under the divine blessing of Paul Mukherjee. Right? So he prayed to the various deities, the five elements, seeking out the divine blessing from Sri Ramachandra. He was eager to listen. So Tulsidas was a great example. It says that Bhagavan Krishna explains in the Bhagavad Gita, so that knowing that you'll be pleased, I am that divine power. Bandhinis in man, says Bhagavan Krishna. Paniya Danta Prithivyamcha. So Paniya represents virtue itself. The dharmic actions, righteous party, those who take the opportunity to see Bhagavan. Just look at the secret act that is performed. It's also called Yagya or Vrat. That is part of Paniya. Paniya means virtue. Virtue is in simple, honest, dedicated. Right? The honesty and the love for Bhagwan, the self and Bhagwan, Krishna, Shiva, somebody believes in Lord, right, Jesus. The love that is there to serve Almighty, which is very important. So it is Paniya that if you are able to remember God, Pratam, Bhakti, Sanhaka, Sangha, then we come to the power of love. In order for God to be able to help us while experiencing problems and difficulties, his divine power. So Bhagavan Krishna says, Paniya, I am virtue itself, my divine presence is here. Where virtuous ones would perform good actions, if by chance the person would help to clean the harmonium for us, and the reason for this, who is eager to hear, and that person we spoke about sattvic in nature, he chanted and singing, he becomes inspired. Paniya Dandha Prithivyamcha. Well, Bhagavan Krishna spoke about understanding God that resides everywhere, not just the seen form of Lord Krishna alone or the form of Bharadurga. He here you see Gandha. Gandha is a secret saint, but that individual, the secret saint, everybody said, from the root itself, like you see, example, the flower, the Chandini flower, if you are able to smell the flower. That is why when you perform puja, Krishna, the deities enjoy while performing the illusion of the secret, the beautiful flower you see. So at the same time, you pray to Lord Surya Yota. You spend the time to look for the beautiful flower to offer for Bhagwan Krishna. The flower is red in color, at the same for Lord Surya. Again, the flower, a yellow flower, yellow representing good fortune, strength, and determination, the color red, you would use that for Lord Surya Yota. The beauty of the flower represents you, the devotee, well attired to perform puja. The Gandha, the secret, the divine scent, the secret scent represents the divinity of God, Sattvic in Nitya, goodness, love, bliss, Dakshapuri. So it says, I am that secret scent, says Bhagavan Krishna. How many of us ever took the time to smell the flower? And the flower is just the appreciation of our love, our gratitude. Bhagavan Krishna sees when you would smell that secret scent from the root. And then, that is considered to be divine and grace and blessing. That is why also to reuse the secret scent from the Agarbhati to purify the sphere. So the deities become satisfied. So Bhagavan Krishna sees, if we understand this, I am pleased. Jivanam sarva bhuteshu tapasvi tapasvishu. See, Bhagavan Krishna, I am the gift of life. See, so with Bhajan. Yes, that's with his gift of life. The Bhajan says, look at that, kushi pranam. Sukhi sanki sanki sukhi sanki sukhi
Kuch tira, na kuch meera. So if it is that you
take the time to pick the flower from Bhagwan. That is why our practice is that we take the flower and offer as a form of gratitude. For Bhagwan has blessed us with the hands, so we use these hands, the human body, the ability to walk properly. So now Bhagwan Krishna says, having been blessed to think, to smell, to taste, to use the senses, the yajna that is performed, when you pick the flower, looking for the secret flower, the scented flower, or a form of love and gratitude to Bhagwan, the inner qualities, the external part of the beauty of the flower that you represents external beauty, well attired to perform puja, like Lakshmi Ma, the inner qualities, the gandha, the mind, the intellect, within the same Bhagavan Krishna he sees here. So knowing that I am here, na kuch tera, na kuch mera, nothing is mine, certainly it's yours. Such a humble individual, he's willing to sacrifice his life, trying to serve and help others similarly whilst performing your duty to serve God. So that is why he says, here, Vijam Mam Sarva Bhutanam Vidhi Patha Sanatanam Arjuna. Know me to be the eternal seed of all beings, that Bhagavan Krishna has blessed all of us. He has blessed us with the ability to think, to move, to perform all actions, right? Accordingly, some of us will be blessed and unfortunately have got the karma, so we will be blind, deaf. But all of us blessed with the gift of life. I am saying buddha, the ability to use the intellect, I will call intelligence. Bala, buddhi, vidya, the buddhi. We have to use our discretion, right? If by chance something is going to happen to you, then you need to be firm, to think, right? Sukhaye sarasati, dukhame lakui. They are all your friends. But when you actually need support, you need Bhagwan, God is there to help you. So it says, buddhi, using that intellect according to time and circumstances, and something is about to happen, then you start to panic, and because you will panic now, and the next person becomes scared, what is going to happen is that eventually you're going to have a situation that's considered very inauspicious or untharmic, and the place now becomes polluted. So mentally poor, unprepared to seek Bhagavan. So it says using your intellect would be able to seek forgiveness, be calm, or try to be firm, chant Hare Ram, Krishna, Guru, psychologically that we need to be prepared, and that comes from his divine intervention. So using your discretion, because all the pandit if you have the call 999, so to use your discretion according to time and circumstances. If by chance you know somebody who's not very educated, who are from the town of Arugat, and you're faced with that situation, and throughout your life you have to think and analyze. And his divine intervention with Bhagwan, the greatness of God, is going to aspire to tell the person, alright, look at what we can. We just give him a short little answer that will give you that wisdom for performing an inauspicious act that he's going to protect. This sense, as we listen again from the Bhagavad Gita, enjoy it. I'm gonna go So simply pray and believe, self-belief is very important. People experiencing problems now, you know, mentally, distress, anxiety. Other people, young people, can become very anxious. Anxiety is a problem that we have. But the first thing that we come back to is to control the mind to remain calm and then chanting the name of Bhagwan. Chanting the low mantras doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to be blessed. So it says, it says, I am the mind itself, says Bhagavan Krishna. We need to be that divine passion to perform your duty, a mission, to accomplish your mission. If a person wants to become a great singer, Shastriya Sangeet, the singer out there, inspire people, the passion, he works towards achieving that. And if it is down, he becomes lost thinking that I really want to become a singer, but not following the steps of the protocol within the verses, the vidhi, the discourse, that what is written, the work that is here for him to make, to study and to comprehend, feeling to perform his duty to achieve that, rather just thinking about that, then he feels to perform his duty. So Bhagavan Krishna says that which is very important and even secret thought, love. Who said that, you know, calm around that people in the beta partner, but a specific love as a companion, which is somebody who's dear to help you in your life, not just somebody who's going to see that you like that person, right? And this human body, the physical body, the spiritual aspect, is that the love that is there, that is none other than the good of Bhagavan Krishna, the right person. So it says, Kripen Kurang Bhavan, Mohitam Nauti Chalanti, Mali Pelanga Vyamsi, Bhagavan Krishna, as we listen in these ceremonies. About Bhagavan Krishna, preferably, people would pray to him, think about him.
He has created the entire world to support us
the divinity of God, everything that we have earned and achieved through His divine intervention. Knowing this, seems Bhagavan Krishna that you should continue to try to pray to Him. Nanman dosh priti mohutha prapadyam dinaradhama maya yapar hrita jnana asuram bhavam ashrita. Says Bhagavan Krishna, those actions, He says, I am unaffected by what you perform in your life. Those, if a person allows his intellect, right, a lack of ability to use his intellect, his mind, and to think and analyze, rather say God is best for us. Even as a young person now, you can speak a lot of my experiences. If you would see a baby or a girl dressed properly, and then you would say, well, that's nice, that's good to see that she's dressed properly. But if it is you are lulled in mind now, you'll see somebody dressed not very pleasant or ill, not a bit. And then if you allow the mind to be corrupted now, an attachment, right? That is why we need to analyze and be focused. And Maya now, Maya is when you feel to analyze and comprehend now, you become trapped by Maya, entangled with negative thoughts, such a person also becomes a sinner. So using His divine greatness, understanding that's the power of God, that is why we are grateful. So devotees have forgot my worship because of failing to understand how great I am, trapped in Maya, sees Bhagavan Krishna. So using that, we speak about, He spoke about four devotees. Tesham jnani nita yukta eka bhaktir vishishyati priyoti jnani yud. So that person, Chaturvidha, who would serve the Lord, and some of us would pray with love. We spoke about four types of devotees. So this one, this person. Spiritual development
the material beings affected.
What's experiencing problems? How is the time long waiting to the Pandit of this? The Swamis, the Raks, the priests, the pastor, the monk, he started, look at me, who we, Sri Lankans, the other people, there are how many of us who come to friends to help us. So afflicted at that point in time, and something has happened, and if the person is sensibly enough, and through the divine intervention of God, then he will be able to think and analyze and remember that. It says the person now, seeker of knowledge, and wise, a person who is eager to print the word, but to learn the scriptures, to learn these verses from the scriptures. But whilst learning the verses from the scriptures, now he will speak and say, this mantra is here to protect you. Padabhang kaun kumar kalavan pavati jnana kharai preta hanuman to help you move negative forces. That mantra is used for that specific reason. Right? Lord Krishna says, that is fine, that is my devotee, if he understands. But he spoke about the man of wisdom, his wisdom. But this was the view from the Sri Lankan palace. Kishkin Tha Tham, before Tha. Material wealth, Bali also was affected. Bali experienced problems throughout his life. The same very formal Bali, Sugriva. But Bali is saying, that janma janma muni ratna karahi antakala kahi bhagatana. But even the yogis, people, when you spoke about knowledge that you are educated, but they sell us that the chanted this is from the Sri Ramcharitmanas. But once you experience any problems, right? Throughout your life, you are going to be tested and challenged. The divinity of God, His divine power, we spoke today the message of greatness of God, is here to help us. Antakali, remember Him before you die. Antakali, chat, mom, you got. Until you remember the Lord, doesn't mean to see that you expect. But again, we chant His name on Tuesday, we chant His name when another day time. Can't be sure when that moment is. Right? So that to remember him, he said that people have studied the scriptures or greater Sri Ramchandra, the power of Bhagwan Shiva, the Yoga Maya, using the specific mudra for that reason, sitting in that posture, everything that you can explain. But the divinity of God to reside here is when the mind pervades, being working to control the mind, the intellect, to find inner peace, such a Ramana. So Bali said, rather than going to bless me or cheer on and ask him for it, you will be blessed with a gift of immortality if you refuse that gift.
He said, we know these are the many stories about you, among all of us, because we did pretty well, very well, to assume the form of a human being, right? But to gain salvation, the subject of Ananda, this itself, is the highest goal that we can show to our lives. So according to the Sri Ramachandra Kamalas, the Jnani, so if a person becomes wise, people materially, we have seen throughout our lives, people become wealthy. So we create a material wealth. What happens is, a nice car, a vehicle, and sometimes you forget the Lord. When you are experiencing problems, you turn to Him, you can still forget the Lord. The person who read the scriptures, studied the scriptures, still sometimes as you know the benefit of doing it, the reasons why, but the actual, the willpower and the love to cherish the Lord, that sangha, that power. If it is, there is no power, you read the scriptures, but you can't chant it properly, it is a self-motivation to pray, to become motivated to chant His name, to know His. So the Katha here teaches us the greatness of God. As I said, to break up, He is bound. He's the divine strength itself, the inner strength, not light. When we look at the light, there could actually mark. A light is lit, and you don't have the vision in this world. That is the representation of the divinity of God, His particular strength. We spoke about the power of song itself, recognizing God, which is present everywhere, the place, the environment. We spoke about the divine, the secret sense. Cherish the moments that we have together, yoga, yoga, paramanda, every moment. It was for this mutual yoga, the devotee, a bhakta, cherish these moments together. And analyze it, because if you prefer to chant the name of Bhagwan, chant His name, listen to good thoughts, the greatness of God resides in good words and inspiration. Anudrigataramvakyam satyamvayatitamchev. So you become happy. You can't achieve everything. And today, all you do, we look at His life. And all of us, we are all challenged. And knowing that God is here. Today, our chant, that is a Saturday, then you have all the calls to speak.
I'm not going to be able to do that. Namaste Krishna Hastaya. you know, the football club would have met with the family here and myself. And today they would have honored him at the Cedar Hill recreational facility with an opening match for the football season. And it was in commemoration of, you know, the love they had for Fadi and the respect they had for this family. You know, they honored the Fadi today in a grand celebration. That match, I think, is still ongoing. Both myself and my family would have joined in that opening ceremony this evening. You know, and it is really a pleasure to see that Fadi may have gone a few months ago, but not forgotten. And I stood here just a few months ago, 7-8 months ago, Baba. And I didn't think I would have been able to speak at that event, at the funeral. But, you know, Fadi gave us that strength and that hope that, you know, and just as you said, Baba, when you quoted from the scriptures, that, you know, Fadi might not be here in body, but the spirit lives on. And I think his soul is in a better place. I believe that because our scriptures teaches us that, you know, while the journey might be ongoing, we learn through our scriptures that he is with Baba, and I think that lesson gives us some kind of comfort, not only for myself, but for the family, that he is in a better place with Baba. So, Lenneth, I know you just said something on behalf of Ali Savita. Ali Savita was supposed to be with us this evening. I too, myself, would have known that family there, and we are praying with that family also. Ali Savita has been a member of this family, I would say, sure, the entire pathway with that Ms. Das and her family would have held events and so on. You know, and she's part of our family. I respect her as a grandmother. Today she's no longer, I won't say she's no longer with us here, but she's fighting for her life. And you know, we pray for her, we pray for her family that she will get over this too. Just this week, Baba, we were sat and spoken. She was planning for her birthday celebration on Monday. You know, satsang and puja, and today she's lying in a hospital in critical condition. So life is really, you know, it's unexpected that these things happen, but we really have to be mindful that trust in God and believe that God has a better plan for these people and everyone that is going through these situations. But as if it is allowed me, I just wanted to read one quote from the scripture. The family here, you know, God's blessings upon each and everyone. I pray for the both parents, the brothers and sister-in-law, brother-in-law, and all the young ones, your mother and her family, God, your relatives are here today. We join with you, Ms. Das, and you know, we are here with you all, both you and Danny. You all have done really well with Fadi, and we pray that Fadi is resting in a comfortable place with Baba. Thank you again, Baba. Sitara.
Thanks for the shame. Now we shall be with DJ and said that there will be challenges. So, DJ will give us directly, but that is going to be between when they have seen the plan, DJ as well. So, you can arrive tomorrow. So, alright, so I'll go ahead and just a few words and then you will do a party. A few words of the party.
A happy evening for all of us here this evening. And I want to let you all know that Fadi had a good life. And he lived the way that he saw it fit. It may not be the right way, or it may not be the wrong way, but that is how he lived his life. But who of us, who are we to judge at how a man lived his life? each person lived their life to suit them. It may not be the best. That is how they live. That is how they know to live. And Fali is a very respectful person. He respects me very highly, and I try to reform him, which I couldn't do. I reformed so much people from the age 40 coming down to 70 years because I taught in school for more than 10 years. And people who was very negative in dealing with people, even their own parents didn't want to see them. And I happened to bring them back. And today these people are teachers. And I am very proud of them. For my birthday, Fali always walk with a bottle. He knew I never used to drink so. He walk with a bottle, a bunch of cream or some kind of thing, and he always bring it. And he never forget when my birthday come to call me. And I always speak to him and try to show him the right path. But God forbid, we don't know where he went wrong. But all of that is behind us now, and we have to turn our attention to pray for him, say a good word for him. For your own self, you need to say a good word for your own self. Like myself, waking up 4 o'clock in the morning and doing the Gayatri Mantra 28 times. Pandit just recite the Hanuman Chalisa. I don't ever go to sleep without doing the Hanuman Chalisa once a day. And that's been going on for months now. And that is what I try to show my friend Fali. I give him some mantras to help him, and it was helping him, but he was searching, and was not building confidence in himself, and that is our downfall as human beings. This moment, I want you all to program yourself and ask the Lord to give his soul a peaceful resting place. That is what we are here for this evening. So we will all bow our heads and take a few minutes silence, and in doing that we ask the Lord to give Fali's soul a peaceful resting place.
Guru Devo Mahesh.
Shanti, Prithvi Shanti, Apa Shanti, Oshagaya Shanti, Vanaspati Shanti, Vishvadeva Shanti, Brahma Shanti, Sarvagam Shanti, Shanti Reva, Shanti Sama, Shanti Reji, Om Shanti, 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 Om Shanti. Thank you.
Yeah, they're looking for the ground. Oh, I gotta do that.